Hi, InspoLang here. My name is Jade. And many of you have been asking about the Language Reactor Chrome extension we have mentioned in our list of Cantonese resources blog posts, which we will link below for you to check out if you're interested. So we have decided to make a quick tutorial to show you how to use it for your Chinese learning journey or any language journey in general. So first, you would obviously have to add it to your Chrome extensions. So we will go to Google and we will search for Language Reactor Chrome extension. Click on this first one that belongs to chrome.google.com and then click on Add to Chrome. Then add extension and you will have it successfully added to your Chrome browser. It will bring you to the site where you can find different resources to use with the extension. Once you add the extension, you can see it up here under this small tab that's shaped like a puzzle piece. You can toggle the extension on or off depending on when you want to use it. You can also click Turn on Sync to allow for all sync devices to also have the extension available. Click on these tabs on the side. There are different videos and channels recommended to you to help you study your selected language, so you can play around with this yourself. There are both YouTube and Netflix resources recommended. Going down to settings, we usually don't touch the settings here, but you can experiment with it if you want to. As you can see, there are a bunch of languages you can choose from. Now let's see how you can use this extension on different videos. Moving over to YouTube, we'll first show you which videos the extension is compatible with. If we search for a show or channel that you want to watch, such as BuzzFeed, Unsolved, or Modern Family, you can see the CC symbol showing up on certain videos. These are the only videos that can work with the extension. For example, we click to watch this clip of Modern Family. We can see the Language Reactor icon at the bottom for us to toggle on and off, and a settings icon on the side. There's also a full transcript of the video on the side. As you can see, the video now has two lines of English subtitles. If we want to watch it with Chinese subtitles to practice our reading, we can click on Settings. As you see, we have both YouTube subtitles languages and translation language. We simply change the translation language to whatever language you want. For InspoLang, we will want a line of Chinese subtitle, and when you close settings, you can see there is the second line of Chinese subtitles we want. Also, when you point at the transcript lines, another line of Chinese transcription will appear beside it. This is great for practicing your reading comprehension. You can also practice your listening skills and vocabulary by watching Chinese dramas and activating English subtitles. For example, if we want to watch this great drama episode that does not have English subtitles, we can do almost the same thing and go to change the translation language. But instead, this time we will change it back to English. Now there you have it! This is a great tool to practice language you are learning while watching something you find entertaining. In our next blog, we will be providing a list of dramas we recommend that you can watch on YouTube or Netflix with the Language Reactor Chrome extension. We love discovering and sharing fun ways to learn a language. The best way to learn is the fun way to learn. Thanks again for watching. Don't forget to click like and subscribe if you like my video. If you would like more Chinese learning contents from me, please visit InspoLang.com for more. I hope to see you again in my next video. Bye bye!